fights his way back up, but Liquid, they're moving back in. Tiger immediately bursted down. The high ground defense gets more difficult as Liquid, now in a 4v5 situation in their favor, will continue onto the T3 tower. And we keep saying it, but while the tombstone's up, it feels just impossible to try and fight into. What? Amar, he'll still jump in. They do find the lane of a Boxy. He's in with a double stun once again. Misha, he'll gate the chain frost off, but it's not going to matter. It will bounce around and do nothing as they found Yuragi. BZM, he's going to be able to TP up, but Liquid, they're still onto that tier 3 tower. I'm not sure if OG really want to try and buy back for this.
There's no pressure, right? Like, tier 2 still stand, you lose a lane of Rax, trying to go for the end game here with the respawns, not really within the zone for Liquid, but you have an amazing time on Liquid's end. You still have the Aegis, gonna be expiring soon. You take one set of Rax, you find that punishment. Like, Amar, he tries to find that angle, it just doesn't pay off. For OG here, Celery, you saw that the way that fight unfolded. You mentioned it's all about initiation. Who is the priority for Amar? Because it's feeling a bit tough.
Decay again, it seems like that's the priority though. ATF, he can sell all he wants. The problem is he doesn't have the backup as he's getting slowed up here. The Stampede, it's already over. All the stacks of hypothermia from Matumba Man just going onto Amar as he's trying to run with the Glimmer Cape, but they keep slowing him down. This Centaur just cannot walk away. His BZM, they're going to try. It might be the last time here for the side of OG to try and give this a crack, but how do they get it done? It doesn't look good. They've got a couple buybacks, but with the Rax under siege now, they'll be holding on to one more unless Liquid want to keep going. They could certainly try for those T4 towers if they wish, but will they? Yuragi, he's going to back off. Mikke, he's trying for the T4 towers. The Frost Shield is going to slow them down just a little bit, but that's all they can pretty much do here, OG. There's the buyback from ATF. That'll be enough for Liquid, I think. Or will it be? They'll keep going under the T4 towers. It's still a 4v5 situation. BZM is not available yet. Matumba, he's the target. He's got the BKB up, though. It's too hard to take the fight. Yuragi in that Shadow Dance in big trouble. Misha already down. Yuragi controlled up. He is gone. GG is calls. Liquid, what a dominant start to this best of three series. It was a bit back and forth as the game went on, but it seemed like Liquid, after they got that secondary Aegis, they just took over completely in this game one.
Yeah, and it was a pretty slow start as well for OG there, right? Like, the lanes didn't quite go out the way you expected. Yuragi had a really rough time. We saw that 5 kills from Zai, all on Yuragi from the laning phase. And it was just tough. For OG, what do you feel like needs to be changed up a bit here before game 2, Celery?
We should also give props to Liquid these last few fights. They really played well around
Absolutely.
The 4 steps. This Lina at bottom, he turned around at the perfect time when they jumped him. They forced him out, and they set up the fight perfectly. It looked